G'day there guys, it's your main man Marky, and welcome back to another episode of r/AmITheArsehole, where we ask the question, is it okay to report your teacher for the things they do outside of school hours? Now, if you love today's bloody good content, I want you to sit back, relax, chuck a prawn at the barbie, smack that like button, and get ready for this spicy story. Let's go. Would I be the asshole if I show my daughter's teacher's Twitch stream to school administration? My daughter is in high school. Last year, she had a younger science teacher, a woman in her mid-20s, who hadn't been teaching very long. About halfway through the year, my daughter and her friends found out this teacher was streaming on Twitch. My daughter doesn't know who found the teacher's stream first, but her friends started watching and clipping everything the teacher did and saved it all on their phones. I just recently discovered these videos when I grounded my daughter from her phone, and I'm shocked to say the least. First of all, the teacher is streaming as some kind of weird big-boobed anime character. She's extremely inappropriate, using foul language, and also making sexual comments super casually on stream. There are probably 50 different clips that I found in my daughter's Snapchat of her teacher doing this. I wasn't sure what any of this was at first, and when I asked my daughter about why she had such weird videos saved, she said, "Mom, we're pretty sure that's Mrs. XXXX. She has the same voice and everything." This particular teacher left the school at the start of this year, but I found out quickly which school she moved to with a Google search. I want to email administration of her new school and let them know the kind of inappropriate activities this teacher engages in outside of work. So I reached out to the parents of some of the other kids in my daughter's group chat. Most of them are telling me to leave it alone and let this teacher live her life, but there is one that's on the fence and kind of agrees with my viewpoint here. My daughter and her friends swear that the teacher never invited any students to watch her stream, and was actually trying to keep it a secret, and had a nervous breakdown last year about them harassing her online, and it's why she went and found a new job this year. I know teachers are allowed to have lives and hobbies outside of work, but I just think this is way too inappropriate to go unpunished. She can't just run away from her poor and unprofessional behavior. If she's going to be a part of this profession, she should be more mindful of the content that she puts on the internet. And I honestly don't think any other parents would be pleased to know that their kids have a teacher that shouts loudly on the internet about which anime character she wants to toss her salad. Would I be the asshole if I show her new school administration her Twitch account? Now in the comments, you would be the asshole. Your daughter is in high school, she is not a child, and content like that shouldn't be a big deal. Teachers have personal lives outside of school, so this really is none of your business. Exactly. And more importantly, the daughter thinks this is the teacher. If it is, it is not the school's business because the teacher isn't involving the school or the students in this activity. But the daughter still doesn't know that it's actually the teacher, they just think it is. It sounds like the teacher is a VTuber, meaning that you can't see them, just the animated character that they created. The voice just sounds like the teacher, which isn't enough evidence. Also, if teachers were getting paid enough to make a full living, would they need side hustles like this? I'm not saying it's fully within her right to do whatever she wants on her time, money or no, but most of the time you hear teachers doing stuff like this, it's for extra cash due to low pay. If it really is the teacher, and she's already had to change jobs because of harassment, OP sending this to the new job would just continue said harassment, and likely leave this teacher in a spot where she's relying even more heavily on the streaming income stream. If OP actually wanted to help the situation, it would be teaching her kid to stop harassing others. The issue isn't the teacher making videos, it's that the kid has over 50 of them downloaded. That is a lot of videos, and pretty weird. It sounds like a group of kids egging each other on to harass this VTuber or something. Telling the new job is just a way of punishing someone for doing something you morally don't like and policing your values. If OP needs to be policing anyone's values, it's the kids. Former teacher, and crap like this is why I left teaching, if a parent from a former school tried a stunt like this, I'd sue them for harassment and possibly defamation of character. Even if it is who OP thinks it is, she has no contact with this teacher anymore, and the incident OP is mad about didn't happen at school. Oh, for the love of God, yes, you would be the asshole. It's not like she was doing it at school or writing her Twitch handle on the whiteboard. Teachers are allowed to have lives and hobbies outside of work that includes adult content. Please get over it, and maybe teach your kid that it's gross to harass her teacher until she has a nervous breakdown and quits. Our next post is titled, Am I the Asshole? Customer tries buying large amount of gift cards, I refuse for likely being an advanced fee scam, end up losing the job. Last year, I worked at a small budget grocery store. A guy wanted three $500 prepaid Visa gift cards. I immediately say, hold on, are you sure this isn't an advanced fee scam? And he says, no, they are for my personal use. That is the response that phone scammers tell people to say if they're asked about why they're buying large denominations of cards. There were two tills at this store, mine and the manager's. For some reason, the manager wasn't allowed to sell that amount of gift cards on their own terminal, possibly an anti-theft measure, but that meant that the $1,500 of Visa gift cards had to be rung up on my terminal. But I didn't feel good about this, so I refused. So I asked the customer what they were for if it wasn't a scam. If he gives me an alternate reason, like, my three kids are all getting PS5s, I would have done it, but he refuses to clarify, and apparently can't even make up a lie. When I refuse to budge, the man leaves. I presume to talk to the scammer outside on his phone. We call up the head manager, and she says, well, we warned him, and that's all we can do. I say that we could do a little more and refuse to participate in this folderol. Let him go somewhere else for his criminal activity. The manager on the floor says that I have to do it because she can't do it on hers, and she literally tries to push me out of the way of my terminal to do it. And I stand my ground as she tries to hip push me, in what must have been a rather pathetic display. She finally says, you can do this or you can leave. So I left. After I cooled down a bit and got lunch, I called the head manager again and asked her, should I even come in tomorrow? It is hard to find people in December, so I am willing to stay on. We can gamble on this not happening again. And she decides that, nah, let's just make a clean break. I say, possibly interrupting her as she waffles, alright then, lose this number. And I hang up on her. It sucks that this guy got taken for a ride, but it also sucks that I basically threw the job away for no gain and he still got taken for a ride. It was a minimum wage job during the pandemic, I wasn't attached to it or anything. A young coworker at my other job didn't understand why I did it. They don't pay me enough to be a hero. My response was, no, they don't pay me enough to be a villain. OP has offered the following explanation for why they think they might be the asshole. I wonder if I should have just sold the guy the gift cards instead of refusing to, based on an assumption. I was almost certain that he was tangled up in this, but I didn't really help him by refusing. Even if he went somewhere else, what have I solved by refusing to do it? Now in the comments, you're the asshole. He didn't tell you what specifically they were for, because he is a private citizen and it is none of your business. Your manager told you to do it. You don't have to do anything you don't want, but you should expect to lose your job. And ethically, your manager was right. You can warn this guy, but you can't live his life for him, and that's not a good reason to refuse service. The only thing I'll say, not to either of your benefits, you could do a better job of warning them. Actually explain the scam and point them to resources, but if they want to buy three gift cards, let them. The problem is you think so little of the customer. I used to be a cashier. We were trained to watch out for things like this, especially when it's a senior citizen doing this, since gift cards are pretty much non-refundable and are hard to track. How would you feel if your elderly parent who lives on Social Security got taken for everything they had? Ever heard about a Prince from Overseas scam? I think that's what the OP was thinking when this happened. Yeah, I'm confused by the you're the asshole votes because in my area, it was illegal to sell so much money on a gift card at one time to protect people from scammers. I guess that doesn't stop people from buying them at different stores, but hopefully jumping through hoops helps people realize what they're doing might be sketchy. Quote, my response, no, they don't pay me enough to be a villain. And then everyone clapped? Right? And can we talk about how OP's manager tried to get them to move, but they forcefully blocked her and said her attempt was a pathetic display? God, this person sounds full of themselves. No wonder they got fired. You are not the manager, OP. You're the asshole. Not everyone who buys mass gift cards do it for a scam, and no one's obligated to tell you why they're doing it. Even if it's illegal, you can't get in legal trouble for selling them. It is literally your job. I once bought 15 gift cards for Teacher Appreciation Week. Y'all treat people like criminals over something that is none of your business. Explain gift card scams, and if they say no, then ring them up and move on. I mean, honestly, you're the asshole. Edit to add, OP is not an asshole for trying to protect the customer, OP is an asshole for deciding the customer's answer wasn't good enough. As if scams are the only reason gift cards are purchased. Personal use is an extremely common term, and it does not mean that it was for a scam. It means that it's none of your business. Our next post is titled, Am I the Asshole for Telling My Husband to Rehome His Cat? So me and my husband have been living together for 1 year. When we moved in together, I brought my 3-year-old American bully, while he brought his 18-year-old cat. We tried to introduce them to one another by initially separating them, then by introducing them to each other's smells, followed by letting them see each other whilst at a safe distance. They appeared to get along, but after a day, the cat began making its dislike for the dog very clear. I tried describing what this entailed, but my previous post got removed due to its going over the character limit. In response to this, we've taken to keeping the dog and cat separated by gates when there was no one around to supervise them. When we're around, we splash them with a small amount of water if the cat begins to fight with the dog. Which worked for a while, until recently, when the cat became relentless in its efforts to go after the dog, even after being splashed with water. As such, we took the cat to our local vet to assess it for any issues. The vet told us that he's perfectly healthy. Another issue that we have to consider is that I'm pregnant. While I'm not saying the cat would definitely be nasty towards my baby, the way it's acted towards my dog has caused me to worry. I brought up the idea of taking the cat to a cat sanctuary where it would hopefully be able to find a new home, in a relaxing environment and without fear of being euthanized, since we can't take it to any family members, since his family is refusing to have the cat, and my family is in the UK. We argued virtually non-stop about this for days until my husband finally agreed to take his cat to said cat sanctuary. However, he is still pretty upset with me. I feel really bad for my husband, however, I do feel like it was the right decision, not only for the dog, but for our future baby. Am I the asshole? Now in the comments, absolutely you're the asshole. It's an 18-year-old cat. Not only is it incredibly unlikely to find a new home, but think about how stressful that would be for the poor thing. Please go back and save his cat. I'd honestly never forgive you if I was in his shoes. I honestly would have left the marriage over this. Not even sorry. She should know how much that cat means to him, with her selfish self. Exactly. Anyone so heartless that they think that a cat with probably less than a year to live should be rehomed isn't somebody that should be trusted with love. I feel so awful for both the cat and the husband. I wouldn't have been able to say okay to giving up my best friend just because my new husband wants me to. So this has me wondering how bad she browbeat him into making such a decision. Rehoming an 18-year-old kitty isn't a thought normal people with feelings have. This post broke my heart to pieces. I don't even know how he must feel to send off such an old cat. I didn't live with my partner for 8 years because he was allergic to my elderly cat, and when that cat finally died at 21 years old, my partner was there for that too. Sure, he was swollen and blotchy as he held me, but we were both crying anyway. Rehoming at 18? That's no way to treat a cat. You're the asshole. Funny how you only seem to be concerned about your dog and what you want. Maybe you should give up your dog too, for the baby's sake. Yeah, that's the lamest part of the whole post. Fear for the baby. Bullshit. And she just admitted her dog was being aggressive too. Also, it's a frickin' pit bull, which she admits fights back the cat aggressively, and she's worried about the cat harming the kid. I got news for ya. I'd rather a kid go 1v1 versus a cat than a pit bull. You're the asshole. The cat is 18 years old. Who would want to adopt an 18-year-old cat with aggressive tendencies? Not to mention how hard it would be on the cat after living with someone for 18 years, then being rehomed. How about rehoming the dog? No? You don't want to give up the poor dog? Didn't think so, as that would be just as bad. Sorry, but it's on you to make it work and keep them separated. Our next post is titled, Am I the Asshole for Making All the Women in My Family Leave After They All Showed Up to My Wedding Wearing White? I, male 33, have a large family. Mostly aunts and female cousins aside from mum, stepmum, stepsister, and grandmother. I don't know how to say this, but all those women I mentioned above are into teasing and joking. They've formed a unit, which I admit is kind of toxic, and they would tease and roast every new woman that enters the family by marriage by setting up tests to see if they deserve to be a part of the family, or roast their looks and styles to the point of breaking confidence and self-esteem down. Then after a few months of teasing, they'd announce that they finally welcomed them into the family. The newest member would join in on the teasing too, which is crazy, as my dad says. When I first introduced my then-girlfriend, now-wife, I made it clear that I didn't want any of the women in the unit to come at her or harass her, not even with a single word. They went behind my back and roasted her looks and job, and I discovered they've been doing it on Facebook. I had them apologize one by one after they gave the, "We're just testing the water to see if she's capable to be a part of the family," excuse. They didn't want to apologize, but once I said I wouldn't invite any of the unit unless they apologize, including my mom, everyone immediately apologized and brought gifts for my wife. First of them was my stepmom and sister-in-law. My wedding was 2 weeks ago. There was talk about the women in the family wanting to pull a prank on my wife by wearing white and called it the ultimate test to see how my wife reacts. My brother warned me, so I announced that if any of them showed up in white, I'd have them kicked out, including my mom. They said this wasn't true, and they would never do such a thing. But they showed up at my wedding one by one, wearing white dresses, and each and every one of them was told to leave after they tried giving excuses by either making scenes or getting the men involved. The senior women of the unit, who were mum and aunts, also showed up in white but refused to leave. I threatened to take harsher action, and Mum was pissed, telling me to step aside. But I didn't let her in. I had her leave, while the men in the family were watching stunned. Dad was on my side and supported me a lot. I felt absolutely awful, because my wedding was being interrupted by them making scenes. My wife was hurt beyond measure, but the women in the family were pissed. My cousin blasted me on social media later, saying I excluded all of the women from the wedding because my wife was so insecure she couldn't handle another woman's presence at her wedding. I had an argument with them, and Mum berated me, saying it was supposed to be a prank, but I said they were taking it too far. Mum said that I took it too far by kicking them out because they were trying to get a reaction from my wife to see if she was one of those bridezillas, and they were going to get changed as soon as the prank was over. But I ruined my own and entire wedding by reacting so aggressively. I stopped talking after she said that I had to bring my wife and apologize. I haven't seen them a lot in 2 weeks, and they've excluded me from everything. Was I the asshole for how I handled this? And I just want to explain that A, this has been happening for years. The men in the family are split on this behavior. Some of them encourage it, like my uncle and cousin's husband. One is now an ex, and some are against it, like me and my dad and brother. B, the women claim that there is nothing hurtful in what they do, because they claimed they are just looking out for us men, and that their goal ultimately is to make sure the women who enter the family are decent. C, my dad always ends up arguing with my mom and grandmother, since they are the ones who started this whole thing with their behavior and attitude towards other women. And D, I'm not sure if I should mention this, but my male cousin, who's a middle schooler, said that he'd make sure to leave the country before even meeting any women because of this, and it made me chuckle. Also, the dresses they showed up in were simple white dresses. Nothing over the top, but still were white dresses. I realized they went ahead with their plans, even after I stated what I would do in that case. Now in the comments, not the asshole. Your family is toxic, and I am so sad for your wife that they would do that, but also so happy for her that she has a husband who will support her and have her back. I'm sorry your family tried to hijack your wedding for a power play, but you did the right thing, and your marriage will be stronger because of it. Can you imagine how the wife's family thought about all of this? If I were the mother of OP's wife, I would be really worried about my daughter being around those women. Good on OP for breaking the cycle, not the asshole. I would have pulled my daughter aside and asked her if she was 100% sure about marrying into this family, and told her that it's not too late to back out. OP, you sound like a good guy, but your family is completely toxic. What your family pulled is sick. If I were the bride's family and saw this level of bullying, I'd be persuading the bride that she can do a lot better. The groom literally chose to exclude half of his family from his wedding rather than allow them to upset her. The family may be toxic, but it sounds like she's still done pretty well. It's definitely deranged. Hazing isn't cute. Getting hazed doesn't prove that someone is worthy. It's just a mean girls club. These women were angry that they didn't get the chance to haze OP's fiancé, so they decided to band together and ruin the wedding. It's not a prank. It's just vicious and cruel. They've proven that they'll stop at nothing to be cruel to OP's wife, simply because they enjoy being cruel and don't want to miss the opportunity. Then they told lies about why they weren't allowed to be at the wedding. If it were me fielding those women on my wedding day, each one of those white dresses would have been considered a self-written ticket right out of my life. Their continued harassment and lying are just proof that they are bad people. Not the asshole. This level of hazing has crossed the line to emotional abuse and blackmail, and that is probably understating it. It's very good you stood up for your spouse. You handled it well, but emotional blackmailers use family to pressure the victims into compliance with the abuse. Most often when standing up to familial emotional blackmailers, it ends with forced no contact for non-compliance. No contact is healthier, but it can be hard to be shunned from the family. Anyway guys, I think that's where I'm going to end today's video. If you did like it, tell me what you thought about it down in the comments below, and make sure to just interact with everyone in this community. I love each and every one of you that I get to see on a daily basis. And don't forget, if you are a Patreon subscriber, I love you. You're on the screen right now with the YouTube members as well. If you see yourself, give yourself a pat on the back. You guys help me continue this YouTube journey. You keep me going. I see you guys everywhere. I see your messages, and thank you so much for supporting me. I really love every single one of you. But with that all said, I'm going to be signing off now, guys. I hope you have a good day, night, sleep, whatever you're up to, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.